What's up, y'all? Another version of Outside the Box, baby. We are here. And today, it's a big deal because my man Mooski's here in the building. Yo.
She's a runner, she's a track star. She gon' run away when it gets hard. She can't take the pain, she can't get scarred. She hurt anyone that gets involved.
Mooski, what up, baby?
It's good with it, man.
I'm animated and hype because you're here. I've been following you the last couple days. I didn't even know you was in the Marines, bro.
Yes, sir.
So first and foremost, thank you for your service.
I appreciate it.
And thank you for everything you do for us. So without you, we can't do any of this. So what's your thoughts on the whole Afghanistan thing? Since, you know, I know you, some of your brothers and sisters are probably there trying to still hold it down. Like, what do you think about it?
You know, it's crazy. Like, somebody was talking to me about it the other day, and I told them, I was like, they were telling me something, man, and it was just like, I was like, I got to go look into this and see what it's about, but I never got a chance to look into it. So I'm kind of like, you know, you might have to give me like a little rundown of what's going on.
I feel the same way, too. I don't know where I stand. Like, do we stay here? Because I've always felt like, and I hate to say this, and y'all could get mad at me however y'all want. I feel like America is always in everybody else's fucking business. That's just me.
Yeah,
that's just me.
A lot of people say that too.
But at the same time, I know sometimes we got to protect borders. I know we got to make sure we are set up in the right places so you could do your job.
Mm.
You agree with that?
Yeah.
So I know that part. But when it comes to religion and when it comes to people trying to claim what they think is theirs, that's where, to me, this fight and how long this fight been going on. This fight been going on way before we were born, way before our great grandparents. This fight been happening since back in the days. And that's why we still fighting to this day. That's just my opinion.
Right.
Well, I could be talking a bunch of caca.
Nah.
But Mooski's here, brother. How you doing, man? Feeling good?
Man. Feel amazing, man.
You living life right now.
Yeah, man.
Fresh off of that summer jam stage.
Yes, sir.
How was that for you?
Dope, man. I love New York.
What was the best part about it? Break it down for me. You know, I work for the radio station, so I want to hear it all.
Word. I mean, just being out there on the stage, man, and just, you know, just vibing with people, seeing people put their phone lights up.
It was crazy,
just showing love, bro. Like, cause you know, this is my first time actually like being able to perform in front of New York. Like,
that's dope, man. Shout out to A Boogie. He came out on A Boogie set.
Out A Boogie. Shout out New York.
That was dope, man. But yo, so give me the rundown on like how you created Trackstar and what was the concept, or was there a real female in your life that actually ran from you? Like, break, I want to hear it all.
So Trackstar is crazy because, so like with my music, man, I always get inspiration from the beat.
Okay.
You know what I mean? So I'm just driving home one day, like vibing the instrumentals, and I played that one and it just gave me a certain feeling.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? It took me to some situations I had before, you know, with certain shorties and stuff.
Gotcha.
So it's just like, I was like, okay, I wanna really dig into that. Like, I really wanna dig in and say what I was thinking, right? Say what I was feeling right there. Like, I wanna see how far I can get this Trackstar concept and like take it. Like, I wanna see how many bars I can create out of this and make it out of real life though.
And you did.
You know what I mean?
You did a great job. I used to play on the radio and then be like, yo, for all you ladies who ain't ready, don't be a track star. Don't be a track star. You know what I mean? I would kind of co-sign what you're saying in the record, but that's dope that you kind of like, because women think it's always men.
Yeah.
It's not always men. Sometimes women are at fault also. So to my gentlemen out there
who
do what they're supposed to be doing, sometimes women just ain't got it in them.
Yeah.
So if they want to run, they're going to run.
Why do you think
they made famous movies like Runaway Bride, Runaway, whatever? Yo, bro, they be scared and they be shook and they be like, yo, I'm out of here.
Hey.
You know, my wife, she's laughing. I just got married, so I'm good. I got a good one. She ain't a track star. You're good, baby. I love you. We outside the box with my man Mooski. So
anyway,
Mooski, new project coming soon?
Yes, sir. Melodic Therapy for the Broken, man. It's in the works right now.
Say it again.
Melodic Therapy for the Broken.
Melodic Theory?
Melodic Therapy.
Oh, Melodic Therapy.
Yes,
for the Broken?
For the Broken.
Oh, shit. What does that mean, brother? Explain that.
It's just, you know, my music
is going to heal some of the broken people?
Exactly. I'm giving the broken people music. And it's gonna heal them melodically. It's melodic therapy.
That's for you, JC and Y. We got some melodic therapy music
melodic
for you.
Melodic therapy, man.
I'm just fucking with you, bro. It's all good. All right, so when you're creating this music, right? We talked about how you went through some of your live experiences, that kind of stuff. Is that the same for this project also?
Yeah.
What's the song that you're most excited about on this project?
I don't know, man. Like,
that's a hard question,
right? That's hard, man. That's hard because I love a lot of the songs on there, man. It's hard. It's hard to pick one.
The question I just asked them is very equivalent to like asking a parent what's their favorite child.
Yeah, for sure.
All right, because he created all these, you know, these songs or these this body of work, and it's almost difficult for him to ask to answer that question.
So yeah,
I get it, brother. But if you had to, which is the one?
The one, damn, that's hard, man.
If you had a bet, okay, how about this? If you had a bet your whole entire career on one song on the new project, what is it?
Sponsor? It's called Sponsor.
All right, so we're gonna check out Sponsor whenever I get that chance.
Because
I'm connected to DJ Rocco, who works at the record label. And maybe we might get a little spike on this. What do you think, Mooski?
DJ Rocco, hey. You know what I'm saying? We got it. We got you. We got
That's
you
what's
for
up,
sure.
bro. I appreciate you.
We got you for sure.
But thank you for coming out to Summer Jam,
yes,
man.
Yes, sir. For sure. I'm glad I got it.
What's next for you? Like, I mean, I know you're already doing big things, and you're kind of like, you're leveling up, and you're doing bigger and better things, and it seems like you're very happy in your space.
Mm.
What are some of the things you'd like to do, I guess, for the next part of your journey?
I want to keep making good music, first of all, and then, It's a lot of different things I want to do with music and outside of music.
Okay.
You know what I mean? I definitely want to, you know, start working the investment side of things, and then on a music tip, I want to get our label up and running. You know, I signed to myself.
That's smart.
Through Capital.
You like, did? Man, you signed to yourself?
Yeah, like
good man, job, bro.
Me and my partner, we got a label, man. W4L, Wealthy for Life Entertainment. You know what I'm saying? So. Like that's definitely like that's definitely a priority.
If you need some people to help you manage money, I got some people I'm connected with who can help you with that.
Right, for sure.
No, dead ass. Business management, finances, all that kind of stuff.
Yeah, for sure, definitely.
So that we can help you outside the box.
Right.
Outside.
Yeah, I like that.
I'm trying to plug. Shout to LL Business Management. Shout to Bruce. Shout to David. Right. Shout to Marius. Shout to Justin, Kobe, all them guys over there doing big things, big artists, big checks, big money, big royalties, big publishing, all that to go. Shout out to y'all. How you feeling so far? You feeling good?
Yeah, for sure.
I like that. My man Mooski's here. We outside the box with it. I'm the man, Jeez. Big Spanish DJ Enuff. Mooski, what's the biggest mistake you've made so far?
The biggest mistake I made so far is
yes.
letting outside opinion. Letting too many people speak on what's going on.
I got you. So your circle when it comes to that has gotten tighter?
Yeah, for sure.
Okay. So right now, if you had a question, is somebody here who could help you with that?
Yeah, like, for sure.
Especially if you made a song, yo, how you feel about that song?
Yeah, for sure.
Who's
for
that?
Sure. Probably Stun and Guala.
Are they here or no?
Yeah, they downstairs.
Probably. Oh, they're downstairs?
Yeah, they probably downstairs.
And those are your people that help you?
Yeah, my brother. Well, okay. Like everybody always helped me. Like they give me their opinions on my music and stuff
right.
like that.
And you cool with that?
Yeah. Like I definitely like you always want to hear, you know, how people feel, how the music
Absolutely.
Makes people feel.
Because, so at that point, you're saying the more the merrier?
Yeah. Well, it really depends because sometimes I have music that I'm shooting for a certain effect or a certain feel, and I'm trying something new, and I understand that some people won't like it. But at the same time, I understand my gift and you know what I'm saying and what I'm trying to do as an artist. So I would still push it. It's just all about my vision at the end of the day. I just want to see how many people can like, I want to see who does it connect with.
I like that. Who's the most famous rapper from Alabama?
Most famous rapper?
Is it Mooski?
Well, see, me, I'm the R&B cat.
Oh, wow. You just said that.
Yeah.
You know, I wouldn't, you know, lately, it's just crazy. I'm an OG. I've been doing this for fucking 25, 30 years easy.
Sure.
But for the first time, I've been having problems navigating where your music belongs in my computer. So lately, I just been throwing everything in hip hop. Like, fuck it. I don't care if they sing. I don't care if they croon. Just whatever. If it's hot shit, just throw in the hip hop crate. That's it. But you just called yourself an R&B artist.
Well, yeah, like.
Is that technically what you think you are?
Nah, I'm just, well, I mean, I don't know what to call what I do. I just know, like, I sing at a rapper's
place. Nah, you do.
You know what I'm saying? So that's what I just always that's say. That. Dope. So you can put me in both of them. I'm just in. I'm in the middle.
I like
you
know that. What I'm saying, but I actually do. That I do agree with.
I can go full R&B or I can go full hip hop.
Like that.
And so that's what I'm gonna get them on the project.
That's. I like that. Those are real hardships. Like for y'all might not think it ain't nothing, but for me, I'm like, yo, where does this music belong? In my laptop. Not yours, but in mine. Because you know, when you think about it, yo, I got 40, 50 years of history under my belt, either from being a fan to being professional, right? So we're listening to my parents' music, we're listening to our great parents' music, you know, grandparents and all that kind of music, all the way down to now. And the music has changed. It dramatically has changed. And there's a lot of stuff that I do enjoy from my parents' era, but I don't want to hear all of it. I'll take some of it. Not all of it, but just some of it. And I think that helps navigate sometimes when new projects come. I say, yo, Mooski's dope. He's not just a rapper, he sings also. He got the R&B shit on deck, he's ready. And you're rhythmic also, so that's dope too. Like, that's good for you. It's good for the culture, period. Because you sonically sound good.
Man, just trying to.
And that's what we're proud of.
Yeah, just trying to do something different, man.
So he's not in the category of mumble rappers at all. He's not in that space. He's not there. I actually hate that term, but it's fucked up.
What, the mumble rapper?
Yeah, I don't like that term. I think it's a disrespect. You know why? I remember back in the old days, you used to watch Steve Harvey and them always shit on like the hip hop when it was coming up, and they always only cared about the R&B fly shit, which I get because they're gentlemen and they wear suits and they're from a different space. Just because we're from a different space doesn't mean we shit on the younger generation. I'm not into that. I've always felt like when you was 15, 16 years old and you was first falling in love with whatever kind of music you was falling in love with, that's what you fell in love with. You can't be mad because you fell in love with some shit. You know, who the hell am I to critique what you fell in love with? It makes no sense to me.
Yeah, that's
you agree? Yeah. No, he's looking at me like I'm crazy. I said, you agree? I'm looking dead at you. Absolutely, I'm talking to you. Are you a drinker, smoker? What do you do? Yeah. Nothing? Cereal?
No, man, I definitely drink them. I love him and I smoke a little bit.
All right, that's what's up. My man Mooski's in the place, baby. Name and project once again?
Melodic Therapy for the Broken.
Melodic Therapy for the Broken.
Yes, sir. Remember that.
Remember that. Please, yo. It's Mooski, it's DJ Enuff. We outside the box with it, baby.